I don't know what's going on, y'all. That is my fourth OBS crash today. I don't know what build of OBS I'm using, but it is not happy with me. This is going to be a mess to try to, like, piece this together for VODs later. Probably won't be able to. Well, we'll see. Maybe I'll just put it in, like, 4 or 5 parts and be like, sorry, everybody, it's in 5 parts. Looks like I didn't actually go offline there. Looks like I'm still live. This looks like I'm still at 200 or 2 hours and 3 minutes somehow. I don't know how OBS just died entirely and came back. Nope, I did lose it. Now I'm back to 1 minute. I don't know. We tried our best and failed. Crash Team Racing, best racing game. That's it right there. The best. This one's still sealed. I don't have anything to do with this one. I just put it in the pile. I got this one from Best Buy, so that's why this one is in good shape and in one piece. Destroy All Humans 2. Speaking of Destroy All Humans, here's the first one. This one also came sealed. Did I also buy this from Best Buy? I don't remember. But it's frankly shocking at this point to get a GameStop game that's sealed. I'm like, what happened there? Did it just come off a truck or something? There's Destroy All Humans. Oh my gosh, I found another sealed game. It's like 3 in a row. What's happening? Digimon Survive. This one was on sale for super cheap. Like I said earlier, disappointed in Pokemon games lately, so let's buy better Pokemon games like Digimon Survive. Did I just break OBS again? Are you serious? What is happening? I don't know what's going on there, but I'm just gonna have to... do like driver updates or something after this. Something is blowing up on my GPU or something. It's just not having a good time. Oh man, anyway. I have like a few more games to go. I just got to get through the end of this and then I can let everybody go and say sorry about all my system issues. We got Tiny Tina's Wonderland next level edition. I really enjoyed Borderlands 1. I really enjoyed Borderlands 2 until I tried to play it a second time. Borderlands 3, I don't know, man, I didn't get into it. And then I was like, look, Tiny Tina, I'm hearing bad things, but I will get it when it's on sale. Here it is on sale. I think this was $10 for the next level edition. It does have, of course, another gouge right there from some jerk taking the sticker off. You know what? Just let me do it. Just let me take those stickers off. You're going to do it wrong. Let me do it. All right, so this... It says next level edition, but this has nothing inside it. There's no code or anything. I hope it's on the disc, but I'm not so sure. Or they didn't give me the right version. This might be the regular version. I don't know. It says it includes Dragon Lord pack bonus content, but I don't see it. So, whatever. Who cares? It's just Tiny Tina Wonderlands. It's just $10. Alright, I got another sticker to peel off. Tales of Symphonia Remastered. This is like the third Tales game I've seen today. We had Tales of Zestiria on PS4. We got that one used, and it came complete. We got Tales of Vesperia. And that one was just disc only, and it made me cry. Now we've got Tales of Symphonia Remastered. Inside it is just the game. There's nothing exciting. There's no little pamphlet. There's nothing. It's just the game. And then we got a sticker I gotta get off here. Save 50%. 50% off of what? I don't know. It's a mystery. We're not telling. Oh, there you go. I found the weak spot, all right. Oh, no, it's not a weak spot. It's a tear. Ah, beans. Ah, beans. All right, I'm going to find a spot. Where are you weak? Gotta be right there. Yep, there it is. There it is. There we go. Now it's coming up clean. Almost clean, except for that tiny little tear. Fold that in half and stick that in there. There, now I got something in there. Save 50%. Hooray. Alright, I gotta go to work on that tiny little spot that ripped. I already lost it. Where was it? There it is, right there, right by your face. Gotta be nice and careful here, because I didn't put a credit card under here. I was like, it's not worth it for this tiny little spot, but I also don't want to gouge it. So, I think we got it. I think we got it. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Just a little bit of schmutz on this one. I wonder if I can get it, just, like, wipe it off. Actually, yes, I think that was all it needed. Just a little wipe. Just a little wiping off. Alright, there's another Tales of game. I've heard this version is really bad, by the way. But, again, for the sale price it was, I was like, whatever. Throw it in. Alright, and then finally, we got the biggest, beefiest boy. Saints Row. Boy, it doesn't even fit on my camera. The Notorious Edition. It's got a big spot up here. Got a little spot here. Other than that, it's pretty good. It just needs, like, cleaned. It's kind of got fingerprints all over it. Again, I'm not even messing with it with gloves on, so it's half of it my fault. So I'm going to see if this comes off without anything, or if I need to hit this with some chemicals. I'm going to say a little bit of chemicals. Yeah, let's do some heptane. Again, should be wearing gloves. Again, that's a lot of work, and I'm on my last one. This is literally it. This is the last game, y'all. Every game has been cleaned after this. We've had our stickers removed. We've had schmutz taken off. All right, so I'm doing heptane here just to kind of weaken up this sticker goo that's underneath here. I'm not going to get it off with the heptane necessarily. It's just there to loosen it. So that then I can come back with my plastic scraper tool. And then it comes up pretty easily. So I'll get all the paper off of here, and then I'll come back one more time with heptane. Well, it was coming off easy. I probably didn't use enough heptane. Got any more left on you, buddy? There's a lot of paper under there. I get it. Turn it a little bit to get myself some different leverage positions. Trying to keep this flat when I can so I'm not gouging into this little plastic sleeve. By the way, let me get this spot off too. There we go. All right, big pieces away. Anything else I'm missing here? Yeah, just a little bit right there. Okay, now let's take our heptane one more time to all the little residual gluey spots that are in there. Then we'll bust this open. We'll take a peek inside and see what we got. There we go. Now it's coming right off. Take that over. Try another side. Did I miss anything? Was there anything on the back side? I don't think so. I think we're good. That's looking pretty good now. Looks like we got all that goo off. See anything in the reflections or anything? Kind of tough on this one. Alright. Looking pretty good. Next step, let's close off our heptane before I can dump it all over my table. And then finally, do a paper towel. And wipe off that heptane that I just put on there, as well as anything else that was on the outside of that case. This is a nice fancy version of it, so I don't mind spending a little effort on this, trying to get this to be nice and clean. Better. All right, how's our sticker spots looking? Can I see it? Can you see it? Looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. Be careful with that. That's like a cardboard. All right, let's see what's inside. Oh, that's fancy. Like a lift-off lid. Then inside, got this little art book guy. That's fun. Fun. This appears to be some sort of poster. I'm not going to open that all the way up, but that's a poster. Here's postcards. That's hilarious. They even have, like, writing on them and stuff. Yeah, they're all, like, little handwritten postcards. That's fun. And then this is, like, little, like, police cards on everybody. Fun. And then finally, the steelbook. Oh, it's got a sticker on the steelbook. I thought I was done. I thought I was free. Hilariously, it's not been opened yet. It's still sealed here. Which, again, good question. Do you want to take that off or cut into it or none of the above? I haven't decided yet. Let me shift this all over a little bit. Can you still see this? Yes. Okay. Why? Why you gotta spoil my copy like this? This is, like, so pristine right now, too. Like, I gotta be so careful not to gouge anything at this point. Keep it very, very flat. Try to find the weakest corner, if any. Oh, there it is. Okay. Got that up. Careful. Carefully. Carefully. Slowly. Precisely. Patiently. Blinkum, get those dirty boys out of here. Welcome on in, Blinkum. How's it going? How's the family? How's you? Everyone's always asking, how's the family? No one's asking, how's Blink doing? You know, enough about everybody else. What about you? Are you taking care of yourself? Are you doing what you need to do so you can be successful for everybody else who needs you? Alright, I'm not keeping this new sticker. This is definitely going away. Crash. Alright, boys, what do we think? Are we leaving this sticker intact? Are we cutting it in half? Are we gonna peel it off? Maybe fold it up and put it inside? I'll tell you what. Either way, we gotta open this up one way or another. So either I'm taking a razor blade to this, which scares me, or we're peeling this bad boy back. You know me. We are peeling. If we can peel a sticker, I am peeling a sticker. Gotta find the weak spot. Ooh, might be right there. Let me see if this one's worse. Nope. It's right here. I just gotta hit it. I had it for a second. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I thought I had it. That bad boy's on there. It says you're supposed to use just a knife to cut this open. It's saying don't do whatever I'm trying to do. Not gonna work. You're just gonna gouge the steelbook. Not worth it. Stop. Peel up. Pull up. Pull up. To which I say no. I refuse. I refuse. No, I don't want to peel this. I don't want to peel this way because I'm likely to tear on this corner over here. Instead, we're gonna peel back this way and up. We're gonna do that. There we go. Trap. There we go. Got that off there nice and well done. Let me just use a little bit of this here stickiness to get rid of the residual stickiness over here. That guy's being a little booger. All right, that's pretty good. Oops. I just realized I was going to keep... All right, get that off of there. Okay, quick question, everybody. Are we going to fold this in? Yeah, we're going to fold this in. We're going to fold this in like a hot dog. Hot dog folds. Love it. You are wonderful. Coffee in hand. Chadley in ears and eyes. As it should be. I also have myself a coffee beverage. We went with the Tim Hortons today. Because they have a new promotion here. If the Columbus Blue Jackets win a game, you get free hot or iced coffee at Tim Hortons. Ooh, this is careful. All right, no codes inside immediately. But this disc was just loose, just dangling. It was just a dangle little boy. Oh no, it's got a scratch on it. Are you serious? Look at that. Right there. What is that? Is that right there? What is that right there? What do we call that? What is that? This is a brand new disc, y'all. How dare you? How dare you do this to me? It's fine. Anyway, like I said, this was just dangling loose in there, which is probably why it has a scratch in it now. There we go. We'll punch that in there. Now we're good. All right, so inside we got a game add-on for the expansion pass. That's nice. Anarchy pack. Criminal customs. Dos Panteros. I think it's like a gun or something. There you go. That's all in there. I'm not gonna show you the codes because that's bad news bears, but there you go. There's our steelbook of Saints Row. Oh yeah, I'm gonna put this guy inside. Tuck that in there. Keep that for another day. Side the lines. There we go. All right, that's Saints Row. Let me see if I can figure out how to put this all back together. That, yep, that's correct. Pop, there it goes. And then put our little sleevey guy on it. Oh, there we go. There we go. The notorious edition of Saints Row. Sweet. All right. You want the rundown? You want to know all the things we cleaned today? Do you want the recap? I've got quite a pile of trash over here. I literally just threw it on the floor. I'm like, I don't even care, whatever. I need to get like a little desk trash can or something. So we got the Notorious Edition of Saints Row. Yeah, we're just gonna All right, here goes. On Xbox One, brand new from GameStop, we got Tales of Symphonia. We got Tiny Tina Wonderlands. We got Digimon Survive. We got Destroy All Humans 1. We got Destroy All Humans 2. One of these came from Best Buy. I already forget which one it was. And then Crash Team Racing, all new on Xbox from GameStop. On PS4, we got Risen, and we got Outriders World Slayer on PS4. And then new from GameStop, we got Game Builder Garage. We got Mako Anomalies. No More Heroes 3, finally. I hate a dirty boy, but I love a post-dirty boy. No More Heroes 3, we got that. Process of Elimination. This is a wild one I hadn't heard of before I saw the sale. But in short, it's like a visual novel detective strategy game thing. I don't know. Sounds kind of like slightly like maybe 13 Sentinels, maybe? Just a little, but like more visual novel than that even. So we're excited to try that one out. Grim Grimoire once more. And then here it is, the superstar of the bunch. Super Mega Baseball 4. Now I'm telling you, this game right now is on sale for $6 at GameStop. I don't know if you have a way of getting one near you without paying the $8 of shipping. I don't know if it's still in stock, but I'm telling you, if you can hear my voice right now, you got to go pick up a copy of Super Mega Baseball 4 for $6. I think you can even get it on PS5, which is probably even better than the Switch edition. But just for me, I can hear you. Like, I'm not a big sports guy. Look, this is Ken Griffey Jr. presents Major League Baseball, the Super Nintendo classic that birthed an entire SNES-drunk human being with a franchise mode. You gotta get yourself Super Mega Baseball. Gotta do it. All right, I gotta get up for this. I have another stack to show you. This is not even all the stacks. I have too many stacks. That's how big this cleaning stream was. Okay, next up, we're on to the GameStop used collection from the buy 4, get 20 / buy 4 for $10 sales. We got Tales of Zestiria. We got Kingdom Hearts. Look how clean these are now, by the way. These were covered in stickers. These were like in the hospital for like, doctor, I'm growing stickers on me. What's happening? And the doctor was like, I got you. Don't worry about it. I got you. I got heptane and isopropyl alcohol and plastic scrapers. You're going to be fine. On PS3, we picked up Hot Shots Golf Out of Bounds. Couldn't believe I didn't own this game already. Speaking of golf games, why not Tiger Woods 13? Why not EA Sports Masters, which is really Tiger Woods 14? Why not add those to your collection for cheap? And speaking of which, Burnout Paradise. I own this copy. I own this game like three different ways. But now I own yet another Burnout Paradise. This was like $250. So I was like, why just have a digital edition when I could have a physical Burnout Paradise? And man, was I happy to get this on a good Xbox 360 case in the year 2023. A great looking clean Xbox 360 game with a manual and everything for $2.50. Oh, I about fell out of my chair. All right, that was good news. Let's have a quick break for bad news. Here's the loose games that I got from GameStop in the buy 4 for 10, 4 for 20 sale. The worst of the bunch, this was Tales of Vesperia loose. I didn't even get a case with this. They were like, here you go, garbage person. Have a disc in a sleeve. Go away. I was going to return this, actually. I was so mad, and I missed the return window. They're like, I'm sorry. You've had this game in your possession for too long. It's now yours. This is your problem. I'm like, you're right, it is my problem. So I've got old NBA games that I've ripped the case, the stickers off of. So I'm gonna have to do a case swap for this guy, I think. And then maybe do a top spot 1-2-3 artwork printing maneuver where I try to find the artwork for Tales of Disperia Definitive Edition and print that off and do that. Just Cause 4 also came with just the case. It actually came in this case with an NHL logo on it, so that's not correct. So they also had to recase this guy. Starbase Utopia. I decided this one again is like too rare of a game to be worth trying to take back and return and get a real case for. And then My Time at Portia, which didn't even give me a real Xbox case, They had to give me a generic case. But again, $5 for a game that you probably should be playing digitally anyway. I don't mind. I'll figure it out. I'll solve that problem later. Still not done. That's still not it. I haven't even shown you the Xbox One games yet. Oh, we're still not done. All right. Also in the 4 for 20, 4 for 10 sale, Subnautica Below Zero. I was saying earlier, I don't even know if I can play this game because I think it's going to make me so motion sick that I just have to lay down. But for the cheap price that it was, I was like, throw it in. Why not? Rage 2, had that physically. Oh, that's out of order. That's okay. I got this one used. Sorry, this is a used purchase, NHL 2022. I just put it back in the pile already. Actually, some of these are used, some of these are new. I forgot I already sorted this. Mortal Kombat X was, or 10 was a used game. We picked up that one. MLB The Show 2021. Did you dirty? They did. What a bunch of jerks. MLB The Show 2021. I got that steelbook. That was nice of them to ship me that to me. Just Cause 3. We got that one used. Grid Legends. I think that was used. I think that was a $10 one. Call of Duty World War 2. Yeah, I mean, for $2.50, you get a Call of Duty game and you think, I'm going to play the campaign mode maybe later. Speaking of Call of Duty, we got Modern Warfare. Also for cheap. Battlefield 4, I own this digitally. Now I got a physical condition. I got a Back for Blood. And look, I can hear you already say, what's going on up here? I did my best with cleaning this one off. This was a mess. We actually brought out the heat gun for this. We brought out this guy. We were like, let's see if this heat gun is going to get off any of the sticker. Spoiler, this is going to be for a future cleaning stream. Not today because I'm out. I'm going to use this on my Blockbuster sticker of Mario Party 3. With a 25-year-old Blockbuster sticker on it that's like, remove this and the game breaks. So we're going to try this heat tool on that. So we gave it a quick shot on this one. It kind of melted it. It's you know what? It's fine. It's Back for Blood. Who cares? We got Age of Wonders Planetfall used. Used our $5 off certificate on that guy. And then Alex Kidd DX, we got that one used as well. So that's our Xbox One pile. I'm going to put that to the side. With just this one sale, your Xbox One Series X libraries are already bigger than mine, which has been building for 10 years. To be fair, when I have a choice between PlayStation 4/5 or Xbox One/X, I choose Xbox and you chose Sony. That's fine. I'm not judging you for that at all. I don't have a PS5 because I have a Calyx Cube and it doesn't fit inside. They made a smaller version. It still doesn't fit by 2 centimeters. What are you doing? You go to jail. Anyway, you pick your Sony solutions. I've been picking Xbox. So I have a very large Xbox One/X library in comparison. But my PS4 collection is relatively small. And my PS5 collection, non-existent. So that's why. This is so hilarious. I just brought a basket for this one. Are you ready for the eBay purchases? Here's your eBay's purchases. This is a dang basket of the garbage. Oh, sorry. Quick Spot was not one of them. This was what was already in my DS. That doesn't count. Exclude that. Exclude Virtua Tennis. This was going to be my letter V beat, and I just abandoned it this week. I give up. Phalanx on Game Boy Advance. This is a repurchase. But it was super cheap, and I bought it. Oh my gosh, how do I even get started in here? Let me just grab a handful. Push that to the side for a minute. In the GameStop sale, we also picked up Sonic All-Star Racing Transformed. Hang on, this is giving me focus issues. There we go. We picked up Sonic All-Stars Racing Transformed because it was like $5. We picked up Lego Adventures because it was like $2.50. We picked up, hang on, there's one more on the, there it is. We picked up Call of Duty Black Ops on DS for $5. I was like, I'm really curious if they can make these portable and good. So we're going to find out. Xbox is honestly the smarter choice because modern physical Xbox is very affordable. And I am a very cheap person, so it works out for me. In the $6 lot, we got mostly garbage, such as Madagascar carts. Phineas and Ferb. I do have the sequel. I didn't have the first one, so I actually am not hating that one. We got some real garbage here. Dagadar, I don't know what that is, but it's, I know that game is trash. Probably the worst game on the DS. Alvin and the Chipmunk Squeak. Well, not exactly excited about it, but what I am excited for is Club Penguin Elite Penguin Force. I actually was looking for this game, and I got it for real cheap. And then most importantly, How to Train Your Dragon, which is like a weird action RPG, kind of like a Pokemon game a little bit, I think. Kind of hidden gem there. These six games cost me like $7 or something. All right, we're just gonna scoot those over. What else is in our pile? Here's a Game Boy Color lot I got. Ultimate Surfing, not why I bought it. Game & Watch Gallery 3, that was a Blink-inspired purchase right there. And then Dragon Warrior Monsters, this lot was like $25, and I think that's the price of Dragon Warrior by itself. So, and been wanting to get that one too, so there's saved me $10. And then Ultimate Surfing, I guess, apparently. It says Natsume, which makes you think it's going to be good. It's, at best, TNC racing, surfing, skateboarding that's on Nintendo. Like, it's basically that game, I think. A Game Boy Color version of it. What else do we have? These were the grossest games of the cleaning collection. This was a whole mess. This looked like a bottle of ink exploded inside of it, which was wild. I've never seen that. So that was disgusting to clean and made me kind of gag. And then Barbie Magic Pegasus is a Way Forward game. That's why you want to buy this one, at least if you're collecting the whole set of Way Forward games. And it had like battery corrosion on it. It was a whole mess, but we got them both working again. Very exciting. Let me get out the pieces and parts I need for this last one. Hold please. All right, are you ready for a $20 lot? Galador, not the reason you buy a $20 lot. Dogs, not it. By the way, I had to clean the crap out of this game. It looked like it was fine, could not get it to run. We gave it like three cleanings and then it worked. Paws and Claws Pet Vet, not why you buy a $20 game. It was this one, Mazes of Fate. Hiding in that lot, $20. I was like, yep, buying it. That's the price of that game by itself at least. Probably more like 40 or 50. It's a first person game, kind of like Dark Spire, I would say. A little bit of like a first person dungeon crawler. A little bit Baldur's Gate, you know, but Game Boy Advance. Great price for that lot, thank you. Super happy to get that one. We're just gonna put that to the side. We'll just throw it over there, it's fine. Next up, by the way, there's something I haven't shown here. This next lot came with a little bonus I didn't get to show off till just now. But we got Barnyard, which I think might be a hidden gem. I played it for like 3 minutes and was like, wait, is this a good game? Is this Hades? It's an isometric little, well, it's kind of more top down than isometric, to be fair. But you like walk around, you can shoot people with your milk cutters. It might be good. Might be good, Barnyard. We'll see. It came with Caesar Palace, you know, whatever, Blackjack. It's not, you're not going to get rid of it because it's not terrible, but you never seek it out because it's just Blackjack. And then in that lot also was Harry Potter. Now, the thing I haven't shown anybody yet until this moment is those came in boxes. I got the box and manual for Caesar's Palace and for Harry Potter Sorcerer's Stone and Barnyard for some reason. Even though this box looks like someone smashed it with a hammer. That's a nice bonus. This wasn't even listed in the description on the lot. It just showed up in the box they sent. Hidden gem, you say? I don't know. Take a peek at Barnyard. Like, look at a video or like something. Or ask, here's what we really need to do. You and I need to do is we need to get Janked Jesus to play Barnyard and be like, you are the person who tells us whether jank Game Boy Advance games are good or trash. Play this for us and let us know if Barnyard has value to it. So I don't even collect Game Boy Advance boxes. I don't even know what to do with those three, honestly. But thanks. Also in this lot was Crash Bandicoot, probably one of the best platformers on the Game Boy Advance. Spy Kids Challenger, it looked terrible actually, but it's Spy Kids, whatever. It was in the lot, who cares? Spyro 2, Super Monkey Ball. I actually already own this, but it was in the lot, so what are you going to do? Spider-Man, Mysterio's Menace. Rayman 3, speaking of platformers on the Game Boy Advance, and then finally Treasure Planet. So all of this was a lot for, I think, like $30 maybe. So it was like, ooh, it's a little high, but it's going to be worth it for Rayman 3. It's going to be worth it for the pair of Spyro games. The Spider-Man game goes for probably $12 by itself. And this Crash game is pretty good too. And again, we might have accidentally gotten a hidden gem in Barnyard without meaning to. Harry Potter, that's a name that sells. And you got a Blackjack, etc. game for throwing it in there. So, oh my goodness, I'm like tired from telling you all the things I got. Oh, also we got Super Punch-Out on Super Nintendo. I had to rebuy it because I lost my copy. Very sad. We're going to fix that problem so I don't have to have sadness anymore. So now we have Super Punch-Out on Super Nintendo. Phew, that's it. That's it. That's the lot. That's the set. That's the thing. I'm technically not quite out of games to clean, but I'm certainly out for today. That was a 6-hour stream. We just did a 6-hour stream of cleaning games and stuff. I also didn't show off the games I'm returning, by the way. So that was like Injustice 2, Outriders, Mortal Kombat 11. I got all of those used, and then they put them on sale new for cheaper than I bought them used. So I'm returning those. But yeah, that was a lot. That was a lot of stuff. I didn't mean to spend that much necessarily, but when you put a game on 75% off, I get anxious about how cheap that is and how, like, and then I look it up on Metacritic, like, what is this game? And it's like, oh, it's an 82 on Metacritic. I'm like, well, then it's gotta go home. All right, we're just gonna take a little back in the box. So, I mean, even just putting this... Oh, yeah, here's Virtual Tennis. That doesn't count. It's fine, though. You can go over here for now. Just even putting these in my collection is going to take me another, like, hour and a half to 2 hours, probably. Adding all these games to my... Game Eye app. But there you go. I think that's going to do it for me. I gotta do some cleanup though. I got piles of stuff everywhere. I got dry erase markers, dry erase erasers, screwdrivers and toothbrushes and erasers, scrapers. We got everything. I gotta put all this stuff away. It's all gotta go back. I used my last Q-tip. No, I got one more. I got one more Q-tip. All right, so I'll refill that. We made it through several system issues where my OBS crashed, my webcam crashed. We fought through all those just so we could finish this 6-hour stream. Now I think it's time to find somebody to raid. Who are we raiding? I really thought Mellow Level would be live by now. Where's he hiding? Man, I don't have anybody I'm following. They all probably are eating dinner like humans. All right, I don't have anyone I can raid after all. Very sad. So I guess that's just going to be me taking it into the outro. Thanks so much, everybody, for coming and hanging out. Thanks for making it through all my system issues. I hope everybody has a great day. Great evening, and I hope the week treats you well going forward. Thanks so much, everybody, for coming in and hanging out. Appreciate it. I'll talk to you all next time. Bye.